tassa bhagavato arahato sammāsambuddhasa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sammāsambuddhasa.
So welcome to Meditation Satsang, Feit Oakes. Arriving for meditation, we'll sit for about a half hour. We'll give a bit of instruction in the beginning, orienting toward tranquility, some bit of concentration, a bit of arriving in the heart. And then in the second half, we'll do a brief go around, sharing our names and things. And then the topic for the evening is really a continuation of last week, where we started talking about the concepts of fullness and interdependence coming from the Mahāyāna, early Mahāyāna non-dual systems, and how we might think about those in relation to the Buddha's early teachings, the teachings on liberation. And so tonight we're going to talk about some ways that ideas of interdependence, doctrines of interdependence from the Mahāyāna came into productive, interesting, complicated colonial contact with German Romanticism and North American Transcendentalism to create the concept of interdependence and fullness and kind of the doorway of joyful immersion in the world as it is, as a path to liberation. So we'll get there, perhaps. We'll start with sitting, or whatever posture is most conducive for stillness for you. So welcome to new folks. And we'll find a posture that allows us to relax the musculature, relax the impulse to move. If you're upright, finding a posture where the spine is well supported to be as tall as possible while being in a restful and easeful energetic state. So being on a cushion, it's lovely to tip the bowl of the hips forward enough that the low back can find something like its natural curve. And if we sit like this a lot, we begin to correct potentially challenges in the low back from chair sitting and challenges in the neck from screen slump. So you can allow the crown of the head to float upward like a balloon on a string, and the chin to soften toward the wall behind you, relaxing the jaw and the base of the skull. Around the eyes, and letting the invitation for ease wash through the body like cool water percolating down through variegated rock and soil and gravel and shale to replenish the deep aquifer in the low belly and the pelvis. Inviting the breath to deepen and fill and empty the body. And so whatever posture we're in, whether chair sitting, back supported, back unsupported, lying down, standing up, cushion or bench, we're going for this easeful stacking of the spine and a free flow of breath and movement and the feeling of energetic fullness from the base of the pelvis through the crown of the head and radiating out into the limbs. with the long breath in the foreground, connecting not just with the sensations of breathing, but with the knowing of the breath. So there's a conscious moment of connection or contact at the beginning of the breath, whenever there's mindfulness and you know that this is the beginning of the breath, when you're not distracted. There's both the physical breath happening and there's the awareness of it. And so this awareness of it is what we also then bring to the foreground as mindfulness. So you're aware of the beginning and the middle and the top of the in-breath and the beginning, middle, and bottom of the out-breath. And really invite this mindful awareness to come into the foreground, even more foreground than the sensation. So sensation is a pathway we use to get there. But when concentration deepens, the sensation can disappear. And so we want to ground ourselves in the knowing of the in and out breath as a meditation object that will last longer, that will be able to be more continuous, less variable than the sensational breath. And so the object of meditation is not the breath or the breath energy moving in the body, although we keep those present. It is really, in a very simple way, just the knowing of the in and out breath. This way, you're not tracking so many different things: the speed of the breath, the temperature, the volume, the sensations, the pleasant, the unpleasant. All of that is vipassana, investigation. In order to first build a ground of focus and steadiness, just the knowing, breathing in, breathing out. You can use words to label the breathing in and out if that helps, or use the one word mantra, buddho, bud on the inhale, do on the exhale, buddho, awake. For today, we'll keep the instructions to that. See if you can keep it simple, not lose the breath. Stitch together one breath to the next, rejecting boredom, rejecting distraction, rejecting trying too hard. And just enjoy this one gesture, knowing the in-breath, knowing the out-breath. close our meditation with the mantra of the name of Kuan Yin, the one who hears the cries of the world while resting at ease. Namo Kuan Yin Pusa, in the melody from the Chinese tradition of Master Hua. Namo Kuan Yin Pusa. 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 Blessings of the great compassionate heart. May all beings be at ease. May all beings know themselves fully, no part left out.